Okay, we're running the Bandit on the A3-4T. And we are going in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice. Looks like a little bit of a hang up on the chute, which has been a problem with that 6-inch chute. But she landed right next to me and somewhat soft landing. Okay, we're showing a maximum altitude of 376 feet. Which is pretty impressive on the little Bandit for that size motor. But yeah, those 6-inch chutes don't seem to want to cooperate too much. But overall, nice flight. Okay, we're running a Wizard on an A8-3, and this is somewhat of an experimental flight, and then I'm trying a different type of tape to hold the motor down in the back. I'm using electrical tape instead of masking tape, because the last time I flew the Micro Zephyr, the masking tape didn't hold, so I'm going to test out some electrical tape on this rocket. And also, because of the problems I've been having with the 6-inch chutes, I tried a different folding method, and we'll see if it may help it deploy and open up a little bit better this time. So with that, looking at the skies, we are clear, winds are calm. We are going in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And hey, we got an open chute for once. It's right overhead. Right into the sun, I'm afraid. So I don't know if you're gonna be able to see this. It landed in just about the same spot as the Bandit did, within probably about 10 feet. Okay, and we're showing an altitude of 392. So that's awesome. So the chute did open, and the electrical tape held the motor. So I would say that everything I wanted to test on this was a success. So, great flight. Okay, we're running the Zephyr Junior Micro on an extraordinary C6-5 motor. If you remember, the first flight wasn't on an A8-3 and it went 350 feet. Second flight was a B6-4 and it went 814 feet. So even though it more than doubles each time, this C motor should put it well over 1600 feet at a minimum. We'll hope for more. The winds are calm, it's a beautiful day to fly, And I have elected to go with the masking tape on the tail only because the heat kind of turned the adhesive on the electrical tape to goo. So I've gone back to masking tape on the motor. I'm also running the 6-inch parachute packed the same way I did on the Wizard, so hopefully it should open up just like before. So with that, I've procrastinated long enough. Skies are clear, winds are calm. We're going in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And boy, it's up there. Okay, we've got deployment. And let me see if I can zoom in. Boy, it is up there. But I can, from what I can tell, the chute is open. So that's exciting. Looks like it's drifting a little bit south, so there might be some winds up aloft. It's got a bit of a spin to it. Wish I could find it on the camera. It's gonna be a bit of a hike, it looks like. It's going to be a long hike. I really don't want to take my eyes off the rocket itself. It's coming down nicely though. I can tell that the chute is I caught it at the very last second there on the camera. All right, we are going to go search for it. Okay, this does happen sometimes. I got an altimeter reading of only 80 feet. So what happens is it got out of range, is what that means. So we're gonna have to wait till we get to the rocket and download the data from the altimeter to find out what the actual apogee was. Now, I say it's going to be a bit of a hike. It's a little deceptive because the rocket's so small, it seemed like it landed 10 miles away. But because of its size, it's probably a lot closer than what I imagined. I got a bead on the direction. There's a tall power line way out there it was in line with, so I'm going to walk toward that power line in front of that mountain. So like I said, the things I wanted to work were obviously a better chute deployment, which we did have. And the motor appears to have stayed in because it did blow out the ejection charge. Now the third goal I wanted to hit was the 1600 foot limit, or apogee. But we won't know that until we actually get to the rocket and download the data. So the search is on. It's got to be somewhere around here, I'm guessing. That's how far I've walked. And this has happened before. I've walked past my rockets and spent a long time looking for them beyond where they actually were. So I don't want to spend too much time too far out. Oh, there's the jackrabbit. Maybe he knows where the rocket is. Maybe he was leading me to it. Okay guys, we must be getting close because my altimeter just picked up a reading on my flight sketch, and check it out. 1759, we broke the 1600 limit I was looking for. That is phenomenal. So we're close because I'm picking up a signal again from the altimeter. That is good news. And what's even better news is I just walked past it and I turned around and there it is. Everything looks in good shape. That was an awesome, awesome flight.